This is my blog, and I commented on it the other day. Made the comment, money creation is much more important than Article 50. Article 50 to trigger Brexit, which was all everything on the news, really, since Wednesday, when Theresa May sent her letter round to Donald Tusk, the president of the European Parliament, I think that's right, and Jean-Claude Juncker is the president of the Commission, and the president of the Parliament was another chap whose name I don't recall. So what I said was that Article 50, if you Google it, comes up with about 500,000 or 500 million hits, and the Chilcott report about 6 million. So let's just do that. Chilcott. I'll make sure I spell it right. Chilcott report. There's 133,000 hits there. And then if we go for the Article 50. There we are, Article 50. Nearly 500 million hits there. Article 50. Get the Wikipedia article up. And then if we do Brexit. Brexit gets 137 million hits, which is actually less than for Article 50, which I find interesting, but your mileage may vary. Anyway, on Wikipedia you have page view statistics. This is the page view statistics for the Chilcott report. Do here, Iraq Inquiry, Wikipedia. Click there. Here it is here. The talk pages. That's where the editors talk about what can go in and out of the article. Very little discussion on this article here, surprisingly. History of this article here. You can see people have made these different changes. 500, have there been 500 changes? There have been a few as you're going along, you can see, and you can dig around in these things and have a look. But page view statistics there tells you how many page views there have been in the last, the last 90 days. Monthly. It's 90 days, and you can mess about with different graphs. But let's just so 13,000 page views in the last 90 days on the Iraq Inquiry or the Chilcott report. Article 50, same deal. We'll just say view history. Page view statistics. Let's go. So that's from 31st and the 12th.
Yeah.
Through here, you can see since it's been triggered, there've been a lot of views. 89,000 page views. So that's considerably more than on the Iraq inquiry. Brexit Wikipedia, 137 million results. Let's view the history. And if we go into page view statistics, give it last 90, 785,000 page views. Now, the Article 50 thing shows that there's a lot more interest in that than the Chilcott report. But Brexit itself, which happened at the same time, within what, 7 days of each other. If you see on the BBC website, perhaps a reason why I did this search, Chilcott. Got two editors' choices here, and there we are, 7th of July, 6th of July. And there's been, on the BBC since then, there's just been precious little. There's a thing on Radio Ulster today, I had a little listen to this, it was quite interesting. But one of the things on this Radio Ulster thing was to do with the Chilcott report. But prior to that, Gareth Chilcott used to be a prop forward. There we are, 31st of July, John Prescott, Chilcott Inquiry, view from the sofa. I mean, there's something about this idea of narratives and the idea of what is in the news and a narrative that's pushed gets looked at. The Chilcott report was about an illegal war, about lying to Parliament, about a war that's caused 2 million deaths, a war that's caused a lot of displacement of people, refugees, a kind of a gateway war, if you like, to Libya and Syria and, you know, who knows what next. And yet it has garnered minimal interest compared to Brexit, Article 50, which has killed nobody. I mean, you could argue that the assassination or murder of Joe Cox was, you could say that one, so that's one, very sad, and that all happened at the time of the Brexit, in the run-up to the Brexit vote, but it's not an illegal war, it's not. In fact, that'd be quite interesting, just out of interest. Let's just do a search on that. Joe Cox. 34.5 million results. Murder of Joe Cox. And I don't want to diminish this by looking at it, but it's kind of relevant in a way to, oh yeah, well, 32,000 page views on the tragic murder of Joe Cox, and here we go. It's I mean, this was absolutely terrible. I mean, I like I say, I mean, this is not meant to be in bad taste. Page view statistics. There we are, 64,000 views. But if you compare that to the Chilcott report, which has had 13,000 views, I mean, that is an interesting point about current affairs, about coverage of news items. And the skewed order of newsworthiness that we find in our concentrated media. This is the third time now I've tried to do this video, so I'm just going to keep going on skewed media. There is a film called Orwell Rolls in His Grave, which I recommend. This film here, which makes a point about how the media, by becoming more concentrated, you know, becomes captured. And this is another point which I made about search terms that garnered huge hits, lots and lots of hits. Sex. See, that's 3.25 billion hits. Money. Two and three quarters, nearly 2.8 billion. And debt. 607 million. Now, the relationship between debt and money is axiomatic, but if we put in, say, money creation, 8.4 million results. Now, okay, it's a more specific inquiry, but as you get nearer to the meat of a subject, or a meaty subject, which is potentially inconvenient or unhelpful to mainstream narratives, you do find that the number of hits drop off. Let's try this one, say X key score. If you know what that is, you've been paying attention. Here we are, X key score. 193,000 results. X key score is the word or keyword search algorithm program used for Echelon and other state spying systems. Let's try Duncan Campbell. Duncan Campbell. Oh, well, that's actually quite good, quite a surprise there. 34,600,000 results. Now then, now that's interesting, because Duncan Campbell, it's the journalist we're interested in, but we've got Duncan Campbell revivalist here, and there must be some other Duncan Campbell, I'm assuming. Here we are, Duncan Campbell artist, revivalist and journalist. It was the journalist which I was interested in. Let's just to do that journalist. 391,000 results. That's actually pretty good. Duncan's work is suppressed. It doesn't come up in search terms for, you know, stuff that you'd want it to. Just watch it prove me wrong. If we put in Echelon, and let's see what comes up. 12.6 million results. I suppose an echelon isn't just the spy program, so yeah, so that doesn't really help us there. But the point I'm struggling to make, and not proving empirically here, apart from with the question of the Chilcott report, because I mean the title of this video is going to be "What the fuck happened to the Chilcott report?" I was talking to a friend about it earlier on Skype, and it's disappeared without trace, that's the point of this video. And I've run a series of blogs on the memory hole, the way that algorithms are disappearing things, in the sense that they go so low down the number of pages. I mean, on a search term where there are literally billions of hits, how many pages in do people actually go? And so if the algorithm is pushing the inconvenient stuff back there, very few people see it. So in fact, if you did a distribution curve, it would have a very long, thin tail, and the front end, the first page, is where most of the action happens, which is why with your web optimization, you want to be coming up in those first few pages. If people are looking for it specifically, then they will probably find you. You want to be appearing on the front pages of YouTube, on the first page or first few pages of your Google search or whatever search engine it is. And that, dear viewer, dear reader, if you do read my blog, which I mean, I wish more people would, you will see that with consolidation of media, which narrows narratives in the first place and provides dominant narratives, which limits the search terms that people may actually sort of type in the first place. But Chilcott report, the Iraq war inquiry, weapons of mass destruction, the WMDs, Dr. David Kelly. Actually, let's put Dr. David Kelly in and see what happens with that. Dr. David Kelly. 70 million results, which was a respectable number of results. I might put some political leaders in as well, but it's a good thing to do. And and then you start to get an idea of Google Analytics. Now, just to kind of complete this as a sort of a bit of a tour around my garden shed, as it were. This is my blog page, and the earnings are of no interest whatsoever because they are a big fat zero. But stats. Now, stats, this is part of Google Analytics, and if I click on audience, you see it will say where most of my page views come from, what browsers they use, and what platform they're browsing from. And I can do it for now. As I record this, there are 122 people browsing in the United States on my blog, 43 in Sweden, 6 in India, 3 in Germany, you know, and 104 of them, that's over half of them, are using Chrome as their browser, 22% are using Safari, 13% Internet Explorer, and 9% Firefox. And the platforms they're using: Macintosh 60%, Windows 32%, Linux 5%, Android 1%, iPhone 1%. Now, that information is available to me, Google Analytics actually gives you much deeper information than that. You can really narrow it down in some cases to IP addresses, and you can actually then run targeted mailings to your audience as it's built up. So this is how the adverts and what have you that appear on your page, this is where they come from. And lots of people don't know that this even exists. And the same thing happens, you know, you get access to similar information on YouTube. I'm not going to log out of that account and into my YouTube account to show you that, but one of the things that I often say to make this point is, have you ever tried to click on a video to play it and it says not available in your territory? Well, that's because it knows your IP address. Your IP address is specific to the country that you're in, and therefore the owner of that media content can designate whether or not they want that territory, that market, to have access to what it has on YouTube for free. In Sweden, people buy a lot of CDs and videos or whatever. I mean, they do stream. Paradoxically, Pirate Bay has its servers, or has had historically in Sweden. And obviously, well, Wikipedia, the reason Julian Assange is in the fix he's in with the Swedish security state was because they were going to locate their servers with the Pirate Party in Stockholm, if you know a little bit about the background of that story. But this is the nature of how what Karl Rove calls the elites, or the, you know, our actors in history, and how they manipulate the information that makes us think that we're free. I believe in free will, and I believe in human goodness. People like Karl Rove, some ideologies don't. They believe in something called determinism. And you'll find a lot of these themes running through my poetry and my writing on my blog, and it's also a really interesting theme running through my friend David Malone's excellent series currently available on Curiosity Stream, which is called Why Are We Here? So anyway, I'm going to wrap that video up here. I'm not going to edit this, I'm just going to put it up as a stream of consciousness. I hope you found it interesting, maybe learned something if you lasted this long. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, please leave a comment. Please, you know, do get on my blog if you and leave a comment. Hardly anybody ever leaves a comment for me on my blog. Living here in the middle of nowhere in Sweden, living the life of a poet and a writer, which I have been quite seriously, to the extent I have hardly picked up a guitar for the last 2 years, it's nice to, you know, to get some of that feedback. I mean, I do talk on Skype to, you know, a number of, you know, close friends, you know, older ones and newer ones. It's nice to engage in the discourse. And with my guitar playing, in fact, I used to get rather more people telling me what a whole pile of crap that was, and I'll take that, you know. Any feedback, negative feedback, is better than, you know, than nothing at all. Anyway, that's, for what it's worth, is all I wanted to say on that. And meanwhile, I must get back to writing my new novel, Conquest of Dough. Thanks for watching. And the direct.